Are you okay? Wake up. Come on, wake up.
Hi. We thought we'd lost you there. Sorry. This will be painful, okay? I just need to stop the bleeding here. Okay? I know. You're being really, really brave, okay? Shards, okay? Good. Do you remember anything, perhaps? I don't know, it's just, I thought I saw something, but it's just, you have to keep really still for me, okay? I'm gonna be removing the little pieces here. We don't quite know what the material is. We don't really know what's been used here, but I think... I'm so sorry if it hurts. Okay. Seems like it's your only wound up here. Is anything else hurting? Apart from your head, of course. Still for me, okay? Kate tells me that you are a very good fighter. I can tell. We were really worried about you, but Kate was sure that you'd be okay. I just, I don't want to lose anyone. Sure that the liquid that was in those things is not gonna contact your skin, or it's not gonna seep into your wounds, okay? So we're gonna have to clean the wound in a moment, okay? Right. Good. Just because, you know, we're still looking for Jinx, and so far we haven't really had any luck, so we figured maybe, you know, we might be lucky this time, but just going to apply some of this. And then just gently dab along here, okay? Good. Okay. So, do you remember where you were when this happened? Okay. Right. So it was just like a regular patrol thing? Interesting. I wonder. Yeah. I'm sure we'll figure stuff out, but actually, now that I'm looking at you, I think We need to update your protection. It seems like quite a lot was blown off. And I don't know if you can tell here, but there are a lot of tears which could easily rip off if anyone were to just tug on it slightly. Here, see? Not really the best option, but we'll see. I could ask Echo to fix you up with something. We'd have to take your measurements, if that's okay. Okay. Good. Just keep still, okay? I'm just gonna disinfect this. And get you all sorted. Okay. Are you cold by any chance? You want me to give you the jacket? I can do that, sure. Of course. That's better, right? Good. Okay, I'm glad. So, I'd say first we measure your face for a new mask, if that's okay with you. And then we move on to the arms. I mean, luckily I don't think we need anything for your legs. Your feet, so we would be doing upper body, arms, and your head. Good. Okay. So, I have my book right here. Do you think you can write that down for me, or shall I do it? I can do it, sure. Of course. So, there we go. I'd say we start around your chin, okay? Gosh, this thing is old. Where did you get this? Oh, okay. Alright. So, I'll be measuring underneath your ear, going down your chin, and the other side. Hold still for me, okay? Good, and the other side. Perfect. Is your wound okay? Good. Very good. Just going to write that down here. How about from the tip of your nose down to your chin? Okay. I want to make sure that there's enough room for you to breathe in. I know that it won't fully cover your face, but there will be, obviously, regions where air will come in. So I'm also going to measure your nose in general. See how long? Perfect. And then we go along the sides as well. Perfect. Okay. And your ears, of course. Good. Perfect. Do you wear the mask behind your ears, or do you? Oh, okay. Ooh. I'll just take down the measurements anyway, just in case Echo feels like whining. So, I'm going to measure from your eye down to your jawline on both sides. Good. So I'm gonna go across your eyebrows, okay? Perfect. Good. And then from your forehead, tip of your forehead down to your chin, just to get this vertical line and horizontal line of your face. Okay. Okay. And then I'm gonna do from the corner of your eye to your temples. I'll be careful I won't touch the wound, okay? But it seems like it's not bleeding anymore. That's good. Just wondering if we should keep it an open wound or if we should actually maybe apply some band-aids. But I think, what do you think? Yeah, I think it should air dry probably. Okay. Good. Okay, good. And this side. Okay. Perfect. And your eye in general, that's very important. We're going to go from the corners of your eyes to the other side of the eye, and then we're going to do top lid to bottom lid. Good. And that side as well. Okay, perfect. And I'm also going to write down some measurements for around the forehead just in case they want to add some like cool designs or whatever. So, good. Give them kind of like an idea of how much space they have to work with, you know? And then we're going to go over the bridge of your nose from one inner corner of your eye to the other one. Okay. I swear you need a new one. Okay. Perfect. And... okay. Keep still for me. Good. That's not too tight, is it? Perfect. So. Okay. And I think we're done with the face part, so I would like to move on to your neck as well as your upper body, if that's okay. Good. So, relax your arms for me. Okay, no muscle flexing or anything, just stay calm. And then I wanna just move around you like so. And we'll give you like, I don't know, about this much of room to move around. Body. And, okay. What kind of protection do you usually wear? I mean, like materials and, you know, anything in particular that you want me to add? Okay. Right. Perfect. Just if you could take a little bit of a step back, and then I'm just going to measure your upper body. Perfect. Okay. Chin up a little bit. Good. Okay. Okay. Perfect. And perfect. And then we're gonna go around you again. Upper body here. Okay, around the bust area, and then we're going to go around the waist area. Okay. Is that too tight? That's okay. Okay, breathe in for me. Deep, deep, deep breath. Okay, we can actually tighten that a little bit more in that case. Okay, deep breath in again for me. Okay, perfect. Let's do that with the upper body again. Deep breath in. And out. Okay, perfect. And that didn't feel uncomfortable? No? Good. Okay. Perfect. Then move on to your arms. I'm just going to measure from like right here at your neck to your shoulders. Good. Both sides. Okay. Perfect. And then I'm going to go around your arm. Okay. So just lift your arms for me a little bit. Just a little. We can just move around. Okay. And this side as well. Perfect. Okay, that's equal on both sides. And then around your elbow as well. Okay. And this side. Which is your dominant hand? Are you right-handed, left-handed, ambidextrous? Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, I just, you know, I probably ask to give you a little more space if it's your dominant hand because, you know, you build up a little more muscle. Important. Wouldn't want it to feel too tight. So we're gonna measure underneath where the armpit is and then move to the elbow and then do that on the top part of your arm as well. Okay, here's the triceps. Up here the biceps. Move around here. Good. Okay, on the other side, make sure it's even. Good. And up here as well. Okay. Perfect. You don't need any new gloves, do you? No. Okay. Just gonna do the lower arm here. Perfect. So I think I can already give this to Echo. I don't really think there's anything more that we have to discuss. I mean, he probably knows all about your, materials and if you should be allergic or something, but I don't think you are, right? No. Okay. Okay. Let's have a look at your wound again. I mean, it seems like it's pretty much healing up pretty well, but I think we might want to put on some more of that balm. Is it okay if I apply it with my fingers? That's fine, right? Just to get a bit more of a precise covering. I wash my hands, I promise. It's just... I think this is actually pretty good, not only for wounds, but overall it's just good for your skin. Or at least that's what they always tell me, so... Okay. Just gonna rub it between my fingers here. And we're just gonna gently apply this, okay? Just all over here. Okay, it might sting a little bit, but it should be okay. I'm sure you'll be okay. Such a good job. Okay. Perfect. I know it stings, it's okay. It won't be hurting for that long, I promise. Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's supposed to help it cool down a bit. Which actually reminds me, I did bring you a little cooling pad. Do you want me to kind of apply it to your head? Apparently this is filled with some sort of Aztec something something magic that it always stays cold, which is nice. So I'll just gently kind of move this across your head here. Cold, or is it okay? Okay. Good. Ideally, you would really want to do this when the wound is dry, but I can see you're in pain, and we currently don't really have anything else to treat the wound, so... Yeah. It just might help with the swelling to make it calm down. You're starting to remember things? What kind of things? Okay, do you remember what the person looked like? Okay, yeah, the... It does kind of sound like her. I really would have hoped that it wouldn't be the case, you know? I just... I always wanted to keep her safe and... not have this happen ever. I couldn't even think about it back then. I was so worried about her all the time and... I hope I can find her soon. And talk to her and explain everything and just be there for her, you know? I'm sure we can help her. I'm sure. It's just a matter of time and... Maybe I'll take Echo with me. We can talk to her together. I just wish there were... more people or different circumstances. But anyway, you really did a great job today. You really did. So thank you for helping us and just being here. So I'll get some fresh clothing for you. Okay? And I might discuss some things with Kate and see if there's anything that she has for me. Information or anything, you know? So, yeah. If you need me or anyone, we're just next door, okay? Good. Okay. I'm glad. Yeah. You can trust us, of course. Yeah. Don't worry. Okay. I better get going. You rest, okay? Yeah, you deserve it. It was a long day. Good. Okay. So, I'll see you later.